Hey, it's Clay, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol BOXL. We will take a look at the 30-minute time frame. Real quick, what do I mean by 30-minute in case maybe you're new to charts? Instead of each one of these candlesticks here representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you normally see, each one represents 30 minutes. So all this here may look like several days worth of time. It's actually today's price action broken down into 30-minute time slices. I like to do this time frame. That does a good job of telling the quote-unquote story of the price and then makes mapping outward levels of support and resistance a bit easier to see. Now, I don't mean to state the obvious, but I will anyways. Very nice movement today, not only from the price action perspective, but you look down here at the volume and well above average volume on the day. So a lot of eyeballs on this one. So let's make some general observations here as we head into next week. And I'm stumbling over my words because remember, tomorrow is Good Friday, meaning the markets are not even open tomorrow. So I guess today is kind of like Friday and the end of the week. So next week, that's where these, all will kind of go into play here. So I apologize, but it just kind of dawned on me. Yeah, the markets are not even open tomorrow on Friday. But first level of support, what I would call the ideal level, would be right here at $4.10. Now, don't get me wrong, if the price falls below 410, I'm not saying the entire chart is destroyed or ruined or anything like that. But yeah, if the price could manage to stay above there, that would definitely be a huge sign of power going forward. Taking a step back and looking at things from the big picture point of view, that is where the purple line there comes into play, the famous 50-period simple moving average, keyword being moving. As time goes by, that line is going to move itself higher and higher. So a very basic yet highly powerful way to judge the health of the move, that right there being defined as the move, just watch that purple line. As long as the price stays above that line, as the line itself moves higher and higher, then the bulls are in full health, the bulls are in full control. How are you going to best visualize that? That is what is being represented. Again, yeah, staying above 410 would be great, but from the grand scheme of it all, as long as the price is above that purple line, the bulls 100% own the chart. What about levels of resistance going into next week? As far as where the sellers are hanging out at, made themselves pretty apparent today, and that's right up there around $4.40, give or take a few pennies there. So keep an eye on that. That'll definitely be an area where if this movement is going to get continuation, that's the hurdle that'll need to be cleared. All in all, though, not even necessarily today, but you factor back into Wednesday too. Past couple of days have been very solid, and as long as the price keeps on chipping away with those higher bases, that is the name of the game. One of the biggest questions I get is, hey Clay, how do you find the stocks that you trade? So what I've done is put together a free resource guide where I talk about the tools that I use to locate stocks that I find interesting and think may have potential. So if that sounds like something that could add value to you as a trader, then click on the image that is up on the screen right now and I will email you the guide. The guide itself is very short and to the point, and best part, it's completely free. Thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions.